How's everyone going? You're back with Jono for another quick math lesson. Today we're going to look at the area of other quadrilaterals, but the only real skill that we need to know is what is the area of a rectangle. This formula, the rectangle is equal to the length multiplied by the base, is the foundation for all the other areas that we're going to look at today. So as long as you've got that formula fully in your mind, I guarantee you're going to find this lesson pretty cruisy. Just a heads up, this is not going to go through the proof of what a parallelogram is or what a kite is. This is just going to look at the shapes, me telling you that this is what they are, and from there, finding out what the formula is to find the area. If you are looking for the properties of these geometrical figures, I am going to make another video for that topic at some point in the future. Stay tuned. So the first one that we're going to look at is the area of a parallelogram. So this is where we've got two sets of parallel lines that are the same length. So it kind of looks like a rectangle has been pushed over. There's only two important measurements that we need for this one. The base there is B, and the other measurement that we need is the height of the parallelogram, and we're going to call that H. What's really important is that we're not looking at the side length or the slanted side length for this one. We do not need this measurement in order to find out the area. So make sure you've got the perpendicular height or the total between those two parallel lines as your height measurement. Otherwise, we're not going to get this one right. So the way to prove the area of a parallelogram is if I take this H line and I make a cut down there and take that whole triangle that's made that I've just colored in blue, I can move that down to the other side of the parallelogram and it actually fits in perfectly. Now, if I think about it, I've taken this away and added it to this side. This thing now looks like a perfect rectangle, and that's actually what it is. So the formula is just the exact same as the length times base, but for this we're saying it's that base multiplied by the height, or h. So we don't have to know anything else for these parallelograms. As long as you've got the two measurements that we are multiplying together, you're going to find the area. Again, just make sure we're not using that side length, we are using that height that goes from that bottom to the top. That's the only way you could make a mistake for this shape. So the next two shapes we're gonna look at actually do have the same formula. So we're just gonna look at kites as a whole, but this also applies to a rhombus. So for these ones, you're always gonna get given two lines that dissect the entire shape or go along the diagonals. And we're gonna call these X and Y. So again, we're not going to have the side length. They're not important for this, but it's the X and Y that are super important. One of the key features of these shapes is that the two diagonals actually make right angles where they intersect. And that helps visualize our proof quite a lot. So the way to visualize this shape actually helps us find the formula from a rectangle really easily. So let's say that I draw a big rectangle around the outside of this shape, something that looks like this. What we can see pretty quickly is for this rectangle, we would have a base of X and a height of Y because they've already been given to us. And now if I break my shape into four kind of quadrants, each side I've got what looks like a perfectly half triangle in each rectangle. And that actually holds up the whole way through. So in that top left one, the kite or the triangle bit is half of that rectangle that I put in. And the same thing for all of the other quadrants as well. So in each quadrant, I've got exactly half of the rectangle. So it makes sense that for the whole kite, it's just half of a rectangle. And that's all that we've got to do. So the formula comes from this kind of visualization. As long as you've got the X and the Y, we just know that if we put a rectangle around it, the kite's going to take up half that space. So the formula is just a half multiplied by X multiplied by Y. Just making sure, again, the only way you could make a mistake here is if you're using the side lengths. So the trapezium is probably the hardest formula to remember, but again, it stems just from this idea of parallelograms and rectangles. So stick with me, it's going to be pretty cruisy. So a trapezium has two parallel lines, A and B, that don't have to be the same length. And then we've got two other lines that just connect that aren't parallel or the same at all. Again, the height of this shape is really important. So we've got that H there. Again, noticing that it's not the side length, it's the distance from the base up to that A point there. Now, the easiest way to see what the area of a trapezium is to actually just double it. So I'm going to put in an exact copy of that trapezium right next to it. And then what I'm going to do is rotate it 180 degrees just to flip it upside down. And so if I flip that in and push it over to my first trapezium, you can see they fit seamlessly. Now I've got something that just looks like a parallelogram. The only thing I've got to kind of think about is what are my dimensions of this one. So because I flipped it, I've got A on the top there, and that must be the B length on the other side. So the entire length of that top must be A plus B. And the same thing happens on the bottom. I had that B length, I flipped it on its head, and that A gets put down next to it. So now this is a parallelogram. I've got two parallel lines that are the exact same length, and because I did exactly copy and paste it, I know those two side lengths are also the exact same length. So this is pretty cruisy. So now all I need to know is, hey, what was that formula for the parallelogram? Oh, it was the entire base, for this it's A plus B, multiplied by the height up, H. But because we're only looking at one of these trapeziums, we just have to, again, multiply it by a half. And that gives us the formula. So the formula is just written out, a half multiplied by A plus B, and we do have to put these in brackets just to make sure this calculation works, multiplied by the height. So again, it's just a parallelogram. It's a half times the base times the height, but the only tough thing to remember is that the base is the bottom, or the B, plus the top line, A. So it's A plus B in those brackets, then multiplied by H. Again, if you can do that, this is a really quick recap. If we have a look at the formula for each one of these shapes, we can see that rectangles are the king. The parallelogram is just the height multiplied by the base, which is just a rectangle. We proved that if we moved it over, it looks exactly the same. So height times base, not using the side length, but the total height. The next one, for the rhombus and the kite, we could see that it's just half of a rectangle, as long as we're using those diagonal lines. So that means the formula is a half multiplied by the height and the base, which is just X and Y, half a rectangle, happy days. Finally, that trapezium, as long as we can see that if you double it and rotate it, we're just left with a parallelogram again. So the trapezium itself is just half of the parallelogram, making sure that we know that the base is the A plus B, or the sum of those two parallel lines. Apart from that, you're absolutely cruising. So I do hope you found this lesson helpful. If you've got any questions, please don't hesitate to leave a comment below, and hopefully I'll see you again soon. Cheers.